Welcome back to C.O.M.E, College Online Ministry and Encouragement. I'm Reverend Jewel Williams here with our October 10th lesson. And we're continuing, and our theme is fear, false evidence appearing real. And we're continuing with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, step into the fire without doubt. Our theme scripture is Psalms 34 and 4. I sought the Lord, and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. So we're continuing in Daniel 1, and we're going to read verse 8 through 21. Let's have a word of prayer. Father God, we thank you, Holy Spirit, that you would help us to gain understanding. And I pray that even though we only have a quick amount of time to go into this lesson, but I pray that you would allow something to be said and heard for those that are listening that will give them the encouragement they need. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So starting at verse 8, it reads, but Daniel resolved not to defile himself with the royal food and wine, and he asked the chief official for permission not to defile himself this way. Now God had caused the official to show favor and compassion to Daniel, but the official told Daniel, I am afraid of my lord the king who has assigned your food and drink. Why should he see you looking worse than the other young men your age? The king would then have my head because of you. Daniel then said to the guard whom the chief official had appointed over Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, please test your servant for 10 days. Give us nothing but vegetables to eat and water to drink. Then compare our appearance with that of the young men who eat the royal food and treat your servants in according to what you see. So I agreed to this and tested them for 10 days. At the end of the 10 days, they looked healthier and better nourished than any of the young men who ate the royal food. So the guard took away their choice food and wine, and they were to drink, and gave them vegetables instead. To these four young men, God gave knowledge of understanding of all kinds of literature and learning. And Daniel could understand visions and dreams of all kinds. And at the end of the time set by the king to bring them into his service, the chief officials presented them to Nebuchadnezzar. The king talked with them, and he found none equal to Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. So they entered the king's service. And every man of wisdom and understanding about which the king questioned them, he found them 10 times better than all the magicians and enchanters in his whole kingdom. And Daniel remained there until the first year of King Cyrus. So the first point I really want to bring out is you to stand up in difficult situations, you must be willing to put your faith to the test. And we can see that in verse 12 through 15, because what happens is, they decided that they didn't want to eat what was being given to them. They wanted to hold on to the customs and what they believed was right. And so here they were willing to test it and put it, they were willing to challenge what was coming their way. And I want us to take into note that earlier in the verse, it said that, in the scripture, it said that God had caused the official to sow favor. And God, if we're the children of God, we have to go into our situations realizing that we have God's favor upon us. So even though it looks difficult, we have to go in with that assurance and that faith that God is going to work it out. And so I believe Daniel stood up in this point, and he said, please test your servants for 10 days. In other words, let us show you what God can do. And oftentimes we have to be willing to step up in situations and say, you know what, I'm going to trust that I have the favor of God, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to say trust and see what God can do. And so the next point I want to bring up is to stand up in difficult situations. You must be willing to attain all the knowledge God allows you to gain. And so we see that when they did stand up and they were tested, what ended up happening is the official said, look, you look better and healthier than the others. And so I'm going to do what that is that you've asked. So I'm going to only give you the vegetables. But also it says that these four men, God gave knowledge and understanding of all kinds of literature and learning. And so because you trust God, when you are confident in God, God will work things out in your favor. They were willing to step out on faith. They didn't doubt, because they could have just gave in and ate what everybody else did. But they were willing to say, no, God. No, God has given us some requirements, some dietary requirements, and we're going to stick to that. And it's the same with us. God has given us requirements. And so we have to be willing to stick to that, even if the norm says no. We have to be willing to stick with that. And then what God will do is he will begin to give us knowledge and understanding and help us to work out and to work within the situations that we're in. He increased. It was God that increased their knowledge. It wasn't just because they were smart. It says to these four men, God gave knowledge and understanding of all kinds of literature and learning. And so we have to be willing to stand up in our difficult situations and know that God will give us the knowledge we need to work out those situations and to be victorious no matter where we find ourselves. And so to stand up, and the next point is to stand up in difficult situations, you must be willing to seek excellence to set yourself apart. And so because they were willing to do things God's way, they kind of, in a sense, gave something for God to work with. If you and I are not willing to set ourselves apart, if we're not willing to do things God's way, then we will just become part of the norm. We'll fit in and look just like the others. And so remember, this was not that these young men that were eating were also Jewish young men. And I want you to understand it, because it said that they brought all of these young men here, but it was just that these four decided they were going to stick to what they knew was right before God. And because they were willing to step out on what they knew was right before God, then God elevated them. God put them in a place to be, to gain more understanding. It was God that was orchestrating the things that was going on. And so then when they find themselves after this time of preparation, they find themselves talking to the king. And in verse 19, it says, the king could not find anybody equal to the knowledge that they had. There was nobody that was equal in their understanding. There was nobody in the magicians, the enchanters, nobody in the kingdom could stand up to what these young men were doing. And so the king put them into service. And I just think that's so interesting that even though they find themselves in this kingdom for a king that does not honor their God, God has orchestrated them so that they're in position so that God can then come in and do what he desires to do. And I'm going to tell you, that's what God does. He'll put you, he'll put me, he'll put us in jobs, he'll put us in situations where there's no Christians and maybe we're the only ones. And the reason he does that is because if we're obedient and we allow him to work through us, then he can then enter into those places where he once was not allowed in. And so we become that avenue. So we have to stand up in those difficult situations and be willing to seek excellence, to give excellent service, and to do whatever the Lord would call us to do. So what's our life lesson? Our life lesson is to stand in fiery situations. You must trust God when you are faced with those difficult situations. See, Daniel and the three Hebrew boys in this particular scripture, in this telling here, they were faced with a challenge. The challenge was to conform and do what everybody else was doing, but they didn't want to. They wanted to hold on to what they believed was right. And so they were willing to get past fear and doubt, because they could have said, well, if we say something, something can happen to it. But they were willing to get past fear and doubt and to say, look, give us this. Let us eat what we know is that we should eat. In other words, test us. We're willing to test our faith. We're willing to test that God is going to show up because we're desiring to do what he wants us to do. And in the end, they were healthier. They look better. Anytime we eat on the things of God, we are going to look healthier than those that are not. We are going to be spiritually healthier when we eat on the right kinds of food, when we eat on the right kind of spiritual food. That's true in the natural, but it's also true spiritually. When we're eating God's word, when we're eating the things that God has given for us to sustain us, we're going to be healthier. We're going to have a better spiritual makeup. We are going to be better in understanding and knowledge. And then through God, because of God, he will open doors for us. And so we're gonna continue with next week, and we're gonna jump to chapter 2 in Daniel. So join us next week as we continue talking about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, step into the fire without doubt. God bless you.